Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome to the Final Fantasy Brave Exvius video. And this is a very, very serious video, guys. Super serious. Alright? This is not a joke. I'm gonna look right. I don't know if I can look directly at the camera. It's not a joke. This is completely serious. And we have Enhance. I should probably show you, right? Enhance Elric Edward here. Higher modifiers. Now he has like, it's like, I'm trying to think, like 40 something mod. I mean, it's nowhere near New Vision level, but it's pretty good for this. And he also gets still gets the modifier increases. He has 300% attack instead of 250%. He has a little bit more modifiers in his passives now with enhancements. We also got a Lumen Burst upgrade, but I don't think that's gonna matter too much, but we'll try it. I'll try to see if we can maneuver it in. Usually it's not a good idea because it's really bad, but maybe it's good now. Maybe it's good. So the trial itself doesn't matter. I closed my eyes and I picked a random one, so this is the one we're doing. Trial doesn't matter. We just want to see what he can do, right? I want to see what he can do, right? I just got him enhanced right now, guys, so I don't know how strong he is, in all seriousness. You know what would have been nice, though, is it let him have triple cast at the start of battle now? That would have been pretty nice, to have triple cast at the start of battle, just saying. That would have been a pretty big increase, because then you can imbue it in peril at the same time. Can't do that right now, though, unfortunate. Oh, he's probably actually, like, maybe if he can, you know, bump up his up their lone priests. That'd be pretty sweet, right? Because maybe we can actually use their lone priests. Pretty sweet. Obviously, they're not going to be doing much damage on the first turn. Not much DPS do a lot of damage on the first turn, so... And we'll have the regen up, so then we shouldn't be taking much damage from the deal. We'll probably take a lot of damage from it, but not much, right? Hopefully not much. So now we have triple cast available to us. We're going to go ahead and imperil, right? Still stuck with 100% imperil, which is unfortunate, but it is what it is. Actually, hold on, no, we can use lock, right, guys? We can use lock instead. Yeah, let's use lock instead. Alright, we perfect dispelled him, we imperiled for fire. More than they can do, so actually they're gonna be doing the cooldown, and they're gonna be doing two times of the enhanced chaining move here. So this is the first time for me seeing how much damage this can do, so this is pretty much almost full power. Pretty good damage for a 7-star unit. To be fair, this is a 7-star unit in a mostly New Vision trial. Ouch. We didn't cover for some reason. There was no covering going on involved in that for some reason. I think we got RNG'd a little bit right there, so that's great. As you can see, he has cover up, so... That's just fantastic, right? Our damage is going to be decreased. Because we know we don't have any... We don't have any way of dealing with that. We don't have any more ways of doing fire AoE fire in Mew either because we used it. I shouldn't have actually used it. I don't know why I did. That was a bit of a mistake. I feel like just starting over. Because, like, this is not good. I can't use Alola Burst because of that reason. I don't even know what I'm trying. I'm trying to, like, figure something out really quickly. There's not much we can do yet. We're stuck. We're stuck for several turns doing this. That's yikes. Still doing good damage. Maybe next turn we can use our Luna Burst then. You know what I could have done? I could have... No, that wouldn't be too good. Could have used maybe... Or Light and View and then... Whatnot, but no. Or Earth and View, I guess, in this case. Okay, now they're actually going to be covering. We got RNG'd. That almost never happens. We should probably use their Luna Burst in the next turn. And even though all the screw up, they do really good damage. Obviously, New Vision, you know, finished this off already. We know that would have happened because I've already proven it with Rain. Rain can beat this in like 2 or 3 turns, so. But we died for some reason. Big mistake. I still don't know how that happened. Maybe you guys can tell me in the comments section. I think it was just because it was RNG. Let's see what their Luna Burst can do. Let's see if this is even worth it. I'll probably restart if it's not. I mean, it did decent damage. It did decent damage. Not the best. But I think that might be because they don't have a Luna Burst damage available to them now. I think because one of them died, of course. So that might be the case. But as you can see there, in a perfect scenario, that probably would have been pretty good, actually. If they were both not dead, and they both had the attack buff and the Luna Burst buff, I think that would have been pretty good. I think they're... Okay, that happened. So... Okay, this is very bizarre. Oh, I think the... This is very bizarre. I think we're just gonna leave it like this, just like how we did before. Because it's just... Maybe I'll restart. Maybe we can do a restart here. I'll do a restart, actually. Let's try to beat this time. Alright, we've restarted. I skipped ahead. We're about where we were before, but this time I did not use his Fire Imbue. I only used his Fire Imperil, so that if they end up dying, hopefully not, at least we'll have Fire Imbue. But I don't think this time... I've used different abilities this time. Like physical mitigation, for sure, this time. That's really strong. We're having some MP problems now, though. I mean, for sure we should be covering this time, because I made sure to use cover every single turn. Yeah, we're good now. I for sure made you use cover every single turn. We need to have some MP problems, though. He has that Mirage up, so you don't want that, right, guys? What? It took all of that. That's unusual. I want to use our Lone Curse this turn, but we're not going to be able to do it. So I just drew triple cast, hopefully we can do it. Hopefully. Yeah, we're good. My reverse potential is really good. We're surviving. As long as our covers work. Yes. As long as our covers actually work, we're good. We are Gucci. Now we can use their loan first. I'll check their loan first. It lasts for 6 turns. With their cooldown, they get 200% loan first damage buff. So, hopefully that'll be lasting as much. Oh, we need to dispel that stuff. Unfortunately, he does not have any breaks in his brave shift form. So that's kind of screwy. A little bit. I mean, it actually does a pretty good burst of damage. I don't think it's better than their chaining though. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comment section down below if you're still watching this. And by the way, this is pretty long. Let me know if this is actually worth doing. I really don't think so. They get a 200% loan burst damage buff, but like it's not enough hits. It's only like 9 hits. It's just not good enough. Okay, somehow he got RNG. We get it, guys. Like, we get it at this point. We can see how much damage we're doing. This is good enough. I don't want the video to be too much longer. Putting the trial's not a big deal. You can see that he can do good damage. I just wish that they increased his count of, oh. I guess that's why we were doing a lot of damage. Whoops. His Lone Burst wasn't maxed. I assume with his Lone Burst max, he'll actually do good damage. Sorry about that, guys. That's not a joke. That's my bad. Sorry, guys. I assume with this max, it'll probably do good damage. Unfortunately, that was my only friend that was enhanced, so I can't just say, oh, we're just gonna go in with Lone Burst max next time. Maybe I'll make a part 2. Probably not, but maybe if you guys want it. I can already tell you that, let's look at his sheet here, 110 times mod, yeah, I mean, with it maxed, it'll probably be good. I assume it'll probably be good. But, oh, he has 100, oh, that's what you do then, that's, okay, so that's really, actually, I didn't look at that. This is really important to use his own burst then, guys. If you don't have someone else who can do more, it's actually now you actually have to use his Lone Burst, I think. Because it imperils for all these elements by 120%. Now I think you kind of have to use his Lone Burst, so. Yep. So his Lone Burst is pretty important. I think it's worth maxing because it's pretty strong with the 200% Lone Burst damage buff and their cooldown that lasts for 6 turns. So, thank you guys for watching. Edward is pretty good, but obviously nowhere near Neo Vision status. But for a 7-star unit with this much attack, and I'm not even trying, by the way, this is lazily built, in my account, that is. 4.4k attack on a non-Neo Vision unit is kind of like unheard of. I don't think I've ever made a 7-star unit that has this much attack. And the reason for that is because he has a flat attack enhancement in his enhancements in one of his passives. That's why he's able to get to this. That's still insane, though. So smash like for this much attack, by the way. Anyways, guys, thank you guys for watching this totally serious and not clown fest video. Totally being serious about this whole video. He is good, though, for real. He probably is the strongest 7-star damage dealer right now. I can't even think of anyone who could do more. chaining damage than him as a 7-star right now. I think he is the best 7-star chainer. Not finisher, chainer. So thank you guys for watching. If you watch all the way to end of this video, make sure to type in hashtag Elric. Why not? Hashtag Elric. And I'll probably be making a brothers video. I want to make a brothers video, guys. I want to show off how they can chain with a lot of other people and stuff like that. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll hope to see you in the next video. Peace.